morning. How you guys doing this morning? Aloha kakahi aka. Oh, I feel better now, the warm cocoa. How you guys doing this morning? God is good?
All the time.
And all the time.
God is good.
Praise God. I want to thank Jesus for this beautiful day and waking us up. Woo! Oh, pushing through still going long weekend. I want to say mahalo to all the supporters that came out to our bake sale yesterday. We had a good time yesterday, honey.
Yeah.
The time went flew so fast. You know, when you get lots to do, the time just flies by. And we had a blessed day. So I want to say mahalo. Thank you, Jesus, for a beautiful day. And another one coming up today. Woo-hoo! I hope you guys came to praise God this morning, to raise the roof for the Lord, because God is good all the time, man.
All the time.
Love it. Well, let's get ready to worship the Lord. Lord, we come into your presence this morning. Come into our humble abode and just have your way. Let's fellowship together. We lift up our voices to you this morning. And we give you all of our full attention and full praise. All right. Thank you, Lord. We shine a light for you this morning. going to continue worshiping our Savior because we are the light of the world. Amen? All right. What scripture is that from, honey?
I forget. My brain is still mush. What is it? What's the verse?
I don't know. I was asking you. Oh.
Just put me on the spot. I'm trying to stop brain today.
City on a hill.
We are the light of the world. Let the light shine through us. The light we shine is for you, Lord, that they, when they see the light within us, they see you, not us. Thank you, Lord, for our worship this morning. We continue to worship you. How great and magnificent you are. We continue to worship you. We magnify your name. We give all our praise this morning. For you breathe life into us. You're still awake. You're still sleeping, I think.
No, it's just probably not.
Giving you my heart and all that is within. I laid all down for the sake of you, my King. And giving you my dreams, I laid down my rights. I'm giving up my pride for the promise of new life. Say with me, church. Giving you my heart and all that is within. I laid all down for the sake of you, my King. I'm giving up my dreams. I'm laying down my rights. I'm giving up my pride for the promise of you.
Thank you, Lord.
Let us all pray. Epulikako. E Yehova Hemalele, ke akua I ka hiko ia I ka nani. Ka ihi ihi a me ka hana hana. Ke ho'o mai ka e ke hozana ke mililani a hohu o ako ne mako ia oe. No laila. E aloho mai oe I ka poi kawa. I a koko mai nei. E ho'o mai ka ia mako a me ka mako mauhana. A e launa pumai kou uhane molele. Me mako I kulike ai. Ka mako lawe lawe ana. Me kau I make make ai. No laila. E ho'o nani ia ai oe I loko o ka inoa o ka makua ki keiki a me ka uhane hamalele. O Holy Jehovah, the God that is filled with splendor, sacredness, and glory, we thank, praise, and we glorify thee. Therefore, have mercy upon us this morning. Gather together, bless us our work, and let your Holy Spirit abide with us all, so that we may be able to do thy work according to your will, Lord. Therefore, we praise thee in the name of the Father and of the Son and the Holy Spirit. And we all say, Amen. Sorry, this one is smaller, aren't it? Well, I'd like to say good morning to you all. Thanks for joining us. We are live out here in Kapolei. Thank you guys. We got people from all over. We want to say aloha to our Ohana over there, all over in Las Vegas. Pastor Brian, I see so much names here. Donna, thank you guys for joining us. Hey, greet each other this morning with a big, big smile, all right? Smile a while and greet. Get to know each other. Thank you guys for joining us once again. You're here live at Light and Life Ohana Church here in Kapolei. We just want to praise God for this beautiful day and for just coming into our presence this morning. You know, God is good all the time. And even when we, even though we go through our struggles, God still, He still pursues, He still heads us forward and always just continuing praise. And we thank Him so much for allowing us to share the gospel and continue to share the gospel. Even despite not being together, we can still be together online. And He makes ways for us to share His message. So I want to praise and thank Him for this. We got a couple of announcements. So we're going to continue Bible studies this Tuesday. Yes, we got to. We got to finish the book we're in. What book we're in, honey? Ephesians chapter 4. We got to finish chapter 4, man. There's only six chapters that we stood there because we took off the last 3 weeks because of things that we needed to do. And so we want to continue this Tuesday for sure. We're going to continue. If you got time, 6 o'clock, we start. We usually finish before 8 o'clock, usually about 7:30. And we also pray. So if you have any prayer requests, let us know. We pray together for all of our prayer requests. And so we're on Zoom. 337-083-9458. If you're not doing nothing, join us on Zoom. We also are on social media with our Facebook Live after our service. We'll upload it to YouTube, and you can see it on YouTube. You can also share it. You know, you can be do your part by sharing the gospel by just clicking share on top of your screen. And if you know those that don't do Facebook, all you got to do is just send the link. So if you go to YouTube or we post a thing, just copy and send it on their text, their email, whatever, and it'll take them right to the Sunday service on YouTube. We also got, for those who do Instagram, there's a little snippet on Instagram. We also post a lot of stuff that happens at our ministry center on Instagram. So if you guys do any of these social medias, that's a way to get connected with us. If not, you can do the old-fashioned way. You can call us up. You can email us. Our information is at the end of our service. But by all means, we look forward to speaking and actually the fellowship with you. Speaking of fellowship at our ministry center, the toy drive is going. It's collecting toys again. We fill up one box. We gave two big garbage bags and two Target bags full of toys to Valoha. And they're actually going to wrap it up right now so that they can pass it out to the Keiki. So thank you guys, all the people who supported. If you cannot, we had some monetary donations that came in too. What a big say mahalo to Judy Hoppo and the Hoppos. My sister on Molokai,
there's a few of them.
Yeah, there's a couple of them. So thank you guys. If you cannot, and one guy came to Ohana, he said, I don't buy toys, but here's $20. Go buy the toys for us. I said, okay, thank you, brother. It was really cool. I want to say mahalo to them for making our toy drive successful, very successful. So mahalo. Also along there, we have kupunas. We call them the kupuna corner now. We got a kupuna corner now at our ministry center. And the kupunas come down, hang out, and they bring crafts for to sell, and they make donations to our church. So a big mahalo to them. And it's just, our corner is being kind of busy. We're busy corner, which is such a blessing, because when we first started, that was the dead zone right there. Was a dead zone. Now it's like alive. And also there's couple Christian
whole row is
We got Give Me a Break, which they help the caregivers. We got the brother right next to him with some awesome bags and shirts about God, and he actually donated two Bibles to us for us to fundraise and make money to support our ministry. We got Kingdom Clothing right across of us now, full in. And we got from Inspire Church. And we get this Jonathan, the monk, that he does spiritual stuff. They do some spiritual stuff there too. But he makes these beautiful drawings, paintings. If you guys want to check it out, come on down. Our lane on 4th Street is vibrant. And it's filled with the Holy Spirit. So I want to praise and thank God for that. You can find us right across of the Waffle Dog. Everybody know where the Waffle Dog snack shop. See Auntie Laverne. If you cannot know, she'll tell you where we are. But come on down and check us out at the Ohana Hale Marketplace. And we want to praise and thank God for the opportunity of sharing the gospel right there in the Ohana Hale Marketplace. All right. We also made a couple of CDs. When I was with my sister and my cousin, we had made a CD because everybody kept asking. And so we made a CD. Was a dedication to my dad, who was our choir director. And so people were asking. And so all I could think was the fastest way was to. So I asked Roy, hey, can you publish some CDs for us so that we can pass it out and people can still get the word of God through songs. So if you guys are interested, let us know. Or just come on down. We have some copies down there at Ohana Hale. A couple of upcoming events. Today is communion. I hope you folks got your elements ready or go get it ready. We're going to do communion together right after our main service. Our toy drive ends on December 12th will be the last day to make your donations for our toy drive. We want to do a Christmas fellowship. Not sure when, but we're going to do something. We got to talk to my board of director right here. And we're also going to do our Christmas service on December 19th. You know, this year has just flown by, but I want to praise it and thank God for once again utilizing our church and just even through the pandemic, having all these different events and fellowship time to praise together. Yeah, it's all, you know, it's all about building the church of God. So fellowship is a big thing for me. And with fellowship, we build the kingdom of God, you know. So I want to praise and thank God that he gives us the opportunity to do so. Well, let's get right into our message for today. And if you can see, look, it's Christmas already. Unbelievable. December has arrived. Before you know it, it's going to be 2022. Well, our scripture reading comes from the book of Isaiah. Isaiah chapter 9, and I'm going to take it from, verse 1 to 3. The great light. All right. Ayako kako helo helo ana iloko oka wanana isaya. Mokuna eva pauku e kahi ahiki ika pauku e kolu. Pene I palapala ia. Aole na e like ka poli me ia kaumaha ma mua. Ika wā I ho'o waha waha ia ai ka aina o zebulona. There you go. O zebulona. A me ka aina o na patali. A mahope iho ho'onani o ia I ka maikai ma kela au au o yereda o gilalia nona kanaka e ona kanaka I hele ma ko poli e ike au nei lako I ka malamalama nui o ka poe Inohon ma ka aina, o ke aka o ka make. Ia lohi mai au nei, ka malamalama ma luna o lako. Ua ho'onui oi I ka lahui kanaka. Ua ho'o ma huahua oi I ko lako ole ole. Ke ole ole nei la ko I mua o. E like me ka ole ole ana I ka ho'o ihi ili ili ai ana. E like ho'i me ka haole ana o ka poe pu'u nau vei. I ka vai vai pio. Our scripture reading in the book of Isaiah, chapter 9, verses 1 to 3, reads as follows. Nevertheless, there will be no more gloom for those who were in distress. In the past, he humbled the land of Zebulun and the land of Naphtali. But in the future, he will honor Galilee of the nations by the way of the sea beyond the Jordan. Verse 2, the people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of deep darkness, a light was dawned. You have enlarged the nation and increased their joy. They rejoice before you as people rejoice at the harvest, as warriors rejoice when dividing the plunder. Let us pray. Lord, I want to praise and thank you for this beautiful day. We thank you for this scripture reading that you have given us this morning. And Lord, may we not just receive your blessings for today, Lord, but we ask that you utilize us to share your message that you have for us this morning. We thank you for always just blessing our lives with so much more, with so much abundance, that you fill us up with your Holy Spirit, and you continue to do so despite our failures. But Lord, we just thank you for the grace that you give us, that you forgive us for all of our sins, not just the sins of our past or the sins that we commit, but also the sins that we're going to commit in the future. Because we know we're human. We make mistakes. But your grace is so sufficient that you lift us up from the darkness and you rise us. And the light that shines within us beams bright for the others to see and to draw them to you. So, Lord, we thank you for utilizing us as a humble servant just to share the word, share the light. For we are the light of the world. Let us not hide our light, but let us stand proud and shine so that others can come to know you too. Bless the hearts that are here to receive you this morning as we receive the word of the great light. Amen. Well, in 2018, there were 12 boys from Thailand and their soccer coach. They descended into a maze-like cave and intending to enjoy an afternoon adventure. Well, due to unexpected rising of the water that forced them deeper and deeper into the cave, it was 2.5 weeks before rescuers let them out. Dive teams, thwarted by the rising water, attempted to rescue as the boys sat on a small rock shelf with only 6 flickering flashlights. They spent hours in the darkness, hoping that someone and somehow light and help would break through. While the prophet Isaiah described a world of brooding darkness, one overrun by violence and greed, shattered by rebellion and anguish. Nothing but ruin, hopes, candle flickering and fading, sputtering before succumbing to dark nothingness. And yet Isaiah insisted this dim despair was not the end. Because God's mercy, soon there will be no more gloom for those who are in distress. God would never abandon his people in shadowy ruin. And the prophet announced hope for his people then and pointed to the time when Jesus would come to dispel the darkness sin has caused. How many of us are feeling like we're in that darkness today? You know, it's amazing that what happened back in these days, it applies to us today. And we know we live in a world of darkness. We know the struggles, the anguish that fear of being alone in a dark place. Waiting for hope, waiting for some sort of light to protrude. Imagine us if it was to close our eyes and be in this dark place. Not knowing who Jesus is. Man, that's a super dark place. The first words of this chapter plainly refer to the close of the foregoing chapter where everything looked black and melancholy. Everything looked like it was done. it's almost over. I remember being in this part where thinking that life was just about to end. But behold, trouble and darkness and dimness, very dark place, yet not so bad, but that to the upright there shall arise light in the darkness. Now imagine, picture yourself back in that same dark place, but knowing Jesus. How would we feel? I think we'd feel different, because we know, knowing Jesus, and we know what Jesus says, that he will never abandon us. He'll never leave us alone in this dark place. In whatever situation he puts us in, we'll never be alone. How much greater is to know that we know, even though we're in a dark place, we still can see his light, because it shines within us. And the evening time, it shall be light. Well, let us look into today's message and today's scripture and see how the Lord turned the distress and the darkness with a promise of hope for the great light. In our first verse, we're going to talk about humbleness of this great light. Nevertheless, he says, nevertheless, there will be no more gloom. Yet at the time of Isaiah's prophecy, God had been patiently waiting for Israel. If you read the chapter before, you know, God's been patiently waiting for Israel to wake up. Hello. Pay attention, Mary. Wake up, smell the coffee. Oh, speaking of coffee, maybe, you know, wake up and smell the cocoa. I don't do coffee because it stuns my throat. And God is waiting patiently. He sent his light afflictions upon them. He sent light afflictions. Yeah? What is light afflictions?
Lightning?
Issues in your life. Yeah? He sends stressful times in our lives. Light afflictions, like it's like carrying baggage. And he sends it. He sends it. He lets Israel go through these times. He lets Israel be overcome by people who are trying to take over the land. And he's been trying to call to them to come into repentance because of their idolatry, because of their sinful ways. This is God's people, yet they weren't living as God's people. And so God allowed things to happen to them. God allowed the stress to come into their lives. See, God allows, excuse me, God allows things to happen in our lives. God creates, he allows Satan to test us, to overcome us at times, and to test us like how he tested Israel. We call ourselves Christians. He sends us to us to not, as a test of, are you really are a Christian? Or are you just saying it or posting it? But are you really walking as a Christian? And he sends us through the dark valley. And as a Christian, we know that even though we go through the darkest valley, what? I will feel no evil. Because why? Because God is with us. But how many of us feel? We go through this valley, but we forget to bring God along with us. How many of you go through that through the day? You get up, you do your devotions, you get ready to go to work, and you go to work, but you left Jesus at home. And then when you get to work, drama. Right? And you're not working at one theater, but you get drama. Right? because we forgot to bring Jesus along. And that's what happened with the people of Israel. Despite knowing what Jesus did to them, or did for them, they still went back to the old ways. They were still worshiping idols. Worshiping idols doesn't have to be like a statue. Worshiping idols could be choosing anything above God. Some of us choose sports above God. Some of us choose friends above God. Some of us choose family above God. As Christians, God should be numero uno in our lives, right? He should be first. And all the prophets spoke of humbleness. And despite what was going on in the previous chapter, Isaiah comes to tell them that, hey, God's been waiting for you, but you know what? Shake it off. Because why? There will no longer be any more gloomy nights. You will no longer be in darkness, because Jesus is going to take over. How has life been affecting you today? Is God patiently waiting for you? Is he still waiting for you to wake up, pay attention, smell the roses? Are you going through stressful times in your life right now? Do we have a hard time making quality time with him? Well, maybe have you submitted to what he is calling you to do? How many of you have submitted to what, you know, you hear Jesus kind of telling you what to do, but you want to do something else? Are you trying to tell him what you want him, want for you to do? Mm. And some of us, we tell Jesus, hey, God, I want to do this for you. I want to share this for you. And Jesus said, wait, I want you to do this. But yet we get ahead of him. We try to tell him what we should do. How many of us do that? Yeah, we look at our parents. They tell us to do something. They say, oh, well, I like to do this. I like to do this. And I like to do that. We get ahead of what Jesus is telling us. And we're not submitting to his calling. We're trying to submit our agenda. Does anything in our lives take preference before God? Let me show you a scripture in Matthew 6. You know, we say that God is always first in our life, above everything. And it comes from this verse here in chapter 6, verse 33 and 34. It says, but seek first, underline that line, first. Seek first the kingdom of God. See, is when we put God first, what happens? Seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. Yeah? If we do that first, and then it says what? And all these things will be given to you as well. If you put God first, he will open doors for you. If you put God first, he will supply more than your needs. And he says, therefore, do not worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will worry about itself. Each day is enough trouble on its own. Hallelujah. God, church, tomorrow's not promised. Worry about today. You got enough about today. Give yourself to God's calling for you. Because why? God knows it all. He knows the perfect plan that was for you. And that's what he shares with you. Stop trying to tell God what to do. unless you want to run into trouble, just sit back and enjoy the ride. Yeah? Sit back and let Jesus take you on that ride for your life. You know, despite failure, God offers a brighter future. And he says he will honor Galilee of all the nations. God has a plan and a future for those he calls his own, his children, his heirs, you and me. And he has promised them, he has promised us a brighter future. Despite what you're going in right now, God has a promise, and his promise is much brighter, a brighter future for us. And in our scripture today, it says, by way of land, or by way of sea and beyond Jordan, the land of his people stretched of land known as Galilee. And it's where Jesus spent most of his life. And it goes beyond Jordan, it says, yeah? Not only promises the Jews. See, God didn't only promise us the Jews, but also he promised. The promise is also for the Gentiles. It's not just for Jews. It's for the Gentiles. It's for anyone who comes to repentance and who believes in him. That's what Jesus has been waiting for. That's what God was waiting for the Israels. He was patiently waiting for them, and he allowed them to go through trials and tribulations. But now he comes by way of Isaiah and telling us today that there's a brighter future if we come to repentance and we believe in Jesus and we put him in our lives. There's a brighter future for you. How many of you want a brighter future? I do. Yeah. How many of you are tired of running into walls? I am. How many of you are trying to seek for that light and get out of the dark place that you are in right now? I don't like the darkness. Let me share with you a scripture in Ephesians chapter 3, verse 6. It says, this mystery is that through the gospel, the Gentiles are heirs together with Israel, members together of one body, and sharers together in the promise of Christ. See, Christ, that's what the gospel is. It's about the promise that God has for us for a better, a brighter future. The promise of a better, brighter future. But we need to humble ourselves and come to God and repent and give our lives over to him and say, Lord, take control and sit back and allow Jesus to work through you. Let's move on to our second verse. Verse 2. The great light has dawned. And now is the time that Jesus tells Isaiah to prophesy this. And the people walking in darkness has seen a great light. On those living in the land of the deep darkness, a light has dawned. Church, today the light is dawned. If you're sitting in darkness, today the light is dawned. Why? Because you are here listening to the word of God. And Isaiah was called to prophesy about the great deliverer. He would save the people from their sins. You know, the scripture reading is not just about talking about that great light. What was the great light? It's amazing that it's what's coming up. Christmas. The birth of Jesus. And that's the great light that we talk about. That's the great deliverer that was delivered to the world because he's going to deliver us from all of our sins. And we are walking in darkness, shadow places. But how many of you are still there? How many of you still walk in darkness? How many of you walk around lost, confused, don't know how to get out of that cave? It's like going into one of those cornfields, you know, the corn maze, and all of a sudden you're lost. Anybody have been lost in a corn or in a maze? Yeah, and you want to get out because you're tired already. You had enough of it, and you just can't. And you cannot even use your GPS to get out of there. That's how people go through life. Some people who walk in darkness, they go through that in their life. But we're here today to let you know that there is a great light. Oh, sorry. Stepping on your cord. There is a great light. There is a plan. The perfect plan. His name is Jesus. And Isaiah spoke of the coming Messiah. That he would not only bring a bright light with him, but he will be the light of lights. He will be the light of the world. So bright that everybody will see him. Let me share with you in John chapter 8, verse 12. It says, when Jesus spoke again to the people, he said, I am the light of the world. And whoever follows me will never walk in darkness. But will have the light of life. Hallelujah. If you want to get out of the darkness, Jesus said it right there. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness. You want to get out of the darkness, out of that deep hole you're in, follow him. Because he is the light of the world. He will show you the way out of that maze. You don't need no GPS. You don't need no help other than Jesus. Allow him to take control of the wheel. And by allowing him is meaning like when you say, Jesus, take the wheel, take control of my life. Stop hanging onto the wheel. How many of you still hanging onto one part of the wheel? You know, if you're on a freeway, what happens when somebody grabbing your wheel and you're trying to drive? Yeah, so pretend you Jesus and the guy sitting next to you, like, grab your wheel. What happens? You lose the control. You're taking the control away from God. You told him, Lord, take control of my life, but you're still hanging on to the wheel. You're still trying to take control. Let me tell you this. Let me fill you in. God does not need your help. We need his help. Allow him to take control, full control of your life. And watch and see what happens. I encourage you to try that. Allow Jesus into your life and take total control of your life and see what happens. Hey, it's like a diet. Do it for a month and see what happens. You might like it. And Isaiah's words stretched across the land. Soon everyone heard about the coming of the Messiah. And wise men came from the east and the west to find him. How many of you have seen that light? Maybe even just for a glimpse. See, Jesus is the beacon of the great light that we talk about today. And he wants to pass the beacon of light on to you. He wants to pass the light on to you today. Like the lighthouse whose beacons are strong. The message is that God is the great light and he wants to pass this light on to you because what he has called us to do is to be the light. He is the light. He passes that torch on to us so that we can be the light, so we can be that, like a, what you call those, you know, the ships in the, or the tower with the light?
A lighthouse?
Lighthouse. He wants us to be the lighthouse. He wants us to be the lighthouse so that the ships that come will know exactly where he is. And who are the ships? All those that we meet. And he's telling us not to be picky on the ships that come. How many of us are picky on the people that come?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? Yeah? And he's telling us, hey, be the light. Stop being picky, man. Your light needs to shine with you 24/7 so that no matter who comes, they can see the light.
Amen.
Even when the storms come and the fog, that light still shines bright through. How many of you guys' lights are shining, or is it just still flickering? In order for lights to shine that bright, he needs to live within us. He needs to live within you. You cannot be the light of the world if he doesn't live within you. You only become a flickering candle. Jesus is the light that draws us to the Father. And he utilizes us to do the same. Then all the ships that pass through us, everyone that passes through us, they see him through you. They cannot see him if he's not living within you. All they see is you. They need to see him. And he entrusts us to use this light to draw others who walks in the darkness and draws them back home to the Father. Let me share with you another scripture in Matthew 5:14-16. It says, you are the light of the world. A town built on a hill cannot be hidden. Neither do people light a lamp and put it under a bowl. Instead, they put it on a stand, and it gives light to everyone in the house. In the same way, let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father, which is in heaven. Hallelujah. Let's move on to our last verse, verse 3. As we rejoice in the great light, he says, you have enlarged the nation and increased their joy. They rejoice before you as people rejoice at a harvest. And warriors rejoice when dividing the plunder. Praise God that there is an enlargement that is destined for you. The restrictions shall be removed. Suffering and persecutions shall blow away. Because God will make it happen. A great freedom of movement an increase will come, he says. Isaiah is telling Israel that the suffering and the persecutions will pass and a great freedom of movement and increasement will come. There's a time of growth and prosperity will happen in our lives. And it will be a joyous occasion. Come on, somebody give me a hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God will increase our life. You will prosper in your lives. And whatever trials and tribulations that you're going through right now, Jesus is coming to tell us that, hey, Isaiah says that, hey, God has got your back. And soon, all your troubles and your tribulations will pass and you will prosper. That's what the Lord has promised us. And our time will come for growth and prosperity. What a joyous occasion. Because God will make it happen. And he will increase our joy. And this joy is going to fill us up. Like that song, "The joy of the Lord is my strength." Yeah? How many of you, when we happy, when we joyful, man, we saw all of a sudden we pumped up, right? Yeah? And Jesus is going to come to pump you up. And he's coming today to pump you up and remove you out of this darkness so that you can only shine the light. We are the light of the world. And God's light will shine upon you and your path. And the darkness that you endure will be removed. Hallelujah. And instead of shame, joy shall shine through you. Instead of shame and darkness, you now walk in the light. And you shine. It's like you would polish your that kind of armor. You know, like the old days before they go on those jousts. You know, the old days they wear all this full on armor. The armor we have is the armor of Jesus, and that's what we gotta do. We prepare ourselves for the war, and walking in this ugly world, we gotta shine our armor. Put on the armor of Jesus and shine that armor so that when we walk in the light and we walk with authority that has been given to us. We don't walk with our heads down or shame. If you walk in a place of darkness, we walk with the light of Jesus. Let me show you a scripture. It says in Acts 13, verse 47, it says, "For this is what the Lord has commanded us." He says, "I have made you a light for the Gentiles, that you will bring salvation to the ends of the earth." Church is coming up today, is what he's been telling us. It was what he told the disciples when he left to go out and share the good news to the ends of the world. And Jesus is telling us today, hey, be the light of the world. Be the light of the world. When you walk, if you are a Christian, wherever you go, people will know you, that you are a child of God. We need to walk as a child of God. We need to walk with a bright and shiny armor, especially when we walk into dark places. We need not fear being a Christian. We need to fear walking with our heads down as being a Christian. Jesus said, to live is to die. If you want to live, you need to die in Christ. If we cannot die in Christ, we're not going to live. Tomorrow's not promised. The word is for us today. Be the light. Be that great light. And as we rejoice, when we can come to this realization, we can rejoice. It's the realization of what Jesus did for us when he set us free from all of our sins. It's a gift of salvation bought with a price. And Jesus paid for that price. He paid the price for our freedom. And he offers it to you today. It's a choice we make. We cannot buy it. We can't buy our way into heaven. It's a choice. It's a free choice. And through his grace, when he died on the cross, he paid the price, the ultimate price that set us free. And now we are no longer slaves to sin. We have a choice to give ourselves over to him because we have been saved. And the choice is to make that choice to come into repentance, to ask God to forgive us of all of our sins and give our lives over to him because we believe that he has set us free. Let me share with you one last scripture in Mark chapter 1, verse 15. It says, the time has come, he said. The kingdom of God has come near. Repent and believe the good news. See, the great light is not just a shiny bright light. Or a bright beam that shines in the darkness so you can see. And even though it has a similarity meaning, let's not be misunderstood that the great light is the Messiah. And his name is Jesus. He was sent to pay the price of our sins, for the sins of the world on the cross, to set us free. Free from the bondage of sins, of all of our sins, past, present, and future. See, Jesus says, come. And now we hear Isaiah's words with renewed meaning. That the people walking in darkness have seen a great light. And Isaiah says, on those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has been dawned. And no matter how dark the night is, or that might it might be, no matter how despairing or our circumstances are, we're never forsaken in darkness. Because Jesus is here. A great light shines. Before I end a message, I'm going to do a story. And this story is entitled Paradise Road. I'm not sure if I said this story. It sounds familiar. And this is written by Catherine Keller. It says, several years ago, we watched a movie called Paradise Road that was based on the true events of a Japanese prisoner of war camp during World War II. And he told the story of a woman who used her influence and training to give a group of women prisoners hope, courage, peace, and unity. All reasons not to give up and keep fighting to stay alive. The women came from different countries and diverse backgrounds. Some were high society, while others had lived on farms. At first, they didn't trust each other, but as life became more difficult, they began to work together. And God used one woman in an amazing way. With her musical talents and organizational skills, she united the women and formed an orchestra. Patiently, she taught them how to use their voices to sound like instruments. And soon they performed beautiful concerts. She succeeded in giving them something challenging and beautiful to focus on, besides their own misery and horrific surroundings. Each day, some of the women died of disease or at the hands of their captors. But the group was able to keep going because of her determination of courage. Of course, some women didn't join the choir and watched from afar, but most did. Over half the women in the camp eventually died. One day when they were having yet another funeral, one of the guards said to her, "Where is your choir now?" And instead of letting his taunt discourage her, she picked up two rocks and began banging out a rhythm. Soon others followed her example, using sticks, shoes, whatever else they could find. They were an orchestra again. And even though those who usually sat and watched joined in the music, eventually the war ended and the prisoners were freed. Many were alive thanks to this woman who had given them hope, courage, and even joy by inspiring them to make something beautiful in dire circumstances. We as God's children are like this woman. The Bible says you shine like stars as you hold out the word of life, Philippians 2:15. You help women see something beautiful in life, no matter the circumstances. You are the light of the world. Think for a moment about the people you influence. Those you meet at your local coffee shop, the grocery store, clothing store, on social media, as well as your neighbors, coworkers, church, and Ohana. God can use you to help introduce people you know to Christ, the one who brings light into our souls and eyes. Let us pray. Father of light, we thank you that you place joy, hope, light, and a reason to keep living in our hearts. Give us the courage to spread that light to everyone with whom we come in contact with, Lord. Lord, bless the hearts that are here that received your blessings today. And Lord, may we find that courage to not walk in darkness anymore, but to stand proud, shine our armor of God, and walk in the light of the Lord. Let us be the light of the world. Let us share this gift with others, to everyone we come across. Even if we don't know them, even if we don't like them, Help us to like them enough to share the gospel. Let us be the light of the world. We thank you, Lord, for allowing us to be the light. Let it shine. Let it shine all the time. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
I want to please thank God for a message for today. And we're going to get right into our communion. We're going to get ready to a communion. You can get your elements together while we sing a song. Our scripture reading for our communion service found in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 11. Reading from verse 23, and it says, "For I have received from the Lord what I pass on to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night that he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, 'This is my body, which is for you.' And he says, 'Do this in remembrance of me.' In the same manner, after he supped, he took the cup, saying, 'This cup is the covenant, the new covenant in my blood. Do this whenever you drink it in remembrance of me. For whenever you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. So then whoever eats the bread and drinks of the cup of the Lord is in an unworthy manner will be guilty of sinning against the body and blood of the Lord. Everyone ought to examine themselves before they eat the bread and drink from the cup. For those who eat and drink without discerning the body of Christ eat and drink judgment on themselves. That is why many among you who are weak, sick, and a number of you have fallen asleep. But if you were more discerning with regard to ourselves, we would not come under such judgment. Nevertheless, when you are judged in this manner or this way by the Lord, we are being disciplined so that we will not be finally condemned with the world." So before we take our communion, let us examine ourselves and let us pray the sinner's prayer and ask the Lord for our forgiveness.
O Lord,
I am wrong in thy commandments.
Lord,
please forgive us.
Please forgive us.
And heal us from all of our sins.
And heal us from all our sins.
Come into our heart.
Come into my heart.
And take total control.
Take total control.
I receive you. as my personal Lord and Savior.
As my personal Lord and Savior.
Amen.
Amen.
Well, let's get our elements together. Lord, we want to bless our bread and our the cup as your represents your body of sacrifice for us and what you've done on the cross. That you set us free from all of our sins, Lord. You paid the price so that we can have eternal life. And we thank you, Lord. Bless these elements that we're about to partake, that it may be a remembrance and healing to ourselves. We pray this in your precious holy name. Amen.
Amen.
Let us all take our bread and raise our bread. This bread represents the body of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who died on the cross for all of our sins. Take, eat in remembrance of him. Amen. You may take. Shall we raise the cup? This cup of the new covenant, which represents the blood of Jesus, which was shed on the cross for the forgiveness of our sins. Take. Drink in remembrance of him. Amen. Oh, yeah, that tastes like wine. Woo. Let us pray. Lord, I want to praise and thank you for our communion service. We thank you for the remembrance of what you've done for us, that you paid the price for all of our sins, Lord. And we thank you. We cannot thank you enough. We thank you for your grace. Then now we have the opportunity to make that choice because you set us free. And that choice we choose is you. We choose eternal salvation, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for the hearts that are here to receive and to commune together with you, Lord. In Jesus' name we all pray. Amen.
Amen.
All right, church, thank you guys for joining us. We want to praise and thank God that for our service today. What more can I say? You guys have a blessed day, and we love you guys. And share the joy of the Lord, man. Okay, prayer requests, that's right. Yes, prayer requests. Hey, if any of you have any prayer requests, please let us know. You can do so by writing down in the comments section. If you want to keep it confidential, you can IM me, or at the end of our message, you see my phone number. You can text me. You can email me. I encourage you, if you want to come down to Ohana Holly, we do have prayer cards there. You can fill them out, and you can put it in our mailbox, and we collect all of our prayer requests. You got to see, I got a stack, man. I got a stack like this from this, just from within this year, from March, I think. When we started there? April, yeah? No, wait. April, May. It was actually from May, June. That's when we started, June. Because we started on, for our first day, we did our service for our third year. So June 1st, I think, or whatever. Anywho, it's from June. We got a big stack of prayer request cards, so I want to praise and thank God for utilizing us in Ohana Holly Marketplace as a ministry, and just to witness what God is doing within our ministry there. Thank you, Lord. So send in your prayer requests. If not, let us go to the Lord and in our service. Epulikako, let us pray. Imamai ke lo o e hova ki a kua, kamakua aloha oi o kamako haku aloha o Yesu Christo. A me ka launa aloha o lo ola na mai o kou o hane e molele. Me ka kou pakahi a pau. May the blessings of Jehovah God, the loving Father of our Lord of love, Jesus Christ, and the love of the Holy Spirit abide with us now and forevermore. And we all say, Amen. Amen. All right. You guys have a blessed day in the Lord. And, hey, share the joy. Hello. Praise the Lord. God bless you guys. Ahui ho, malama pono. Okay, hey, bye bye. Sayonara, shay shay, kansamira. Okie dokie.